Thank you very much for the honor. This is the first time for me that I'm here at NBAR, and I'm quite really taken in by the energy and the whole verve and vigor, and the fact that people have been waiting around, standing there, clapping away, and you know, just not getting tired, says a lot about the strength of NBAR as a brand. And it is something that is, you know, the entire news industry respects, loves, and cherishes. I think the most important thing about for me to get this award is that it's a non-nominated category. We had not entered this category or you know, sought or ever even expected, and therefore for me it has been a delight that it, you know, the jury decided to accord me such a recognition and prestige. I'm really, really honored. It is so, so special. Thank you very much, NBAR jury and Exchange for Media. 2020 is a watershed year, and that's a cliched you know, phrase. Everybody says that. I think it's been a lot more than being a cliched you know, watershed year. 2020 actually just picked us up and pushed us straight to meet our future. A future that we thought was at least 3 to 5 years away was suddenly placed right in front of us. At once thrilling and scary. And I think those companies, those products, those channels, those people have actually done well that have been able to keep pace with this change. I think the most important factor about 2020, when we talk about this year in the future, will be the pace and acceleration and the whole cutting shot of, you just picked up from a place and put on the horizon. The horizon was so far away, and suddenly you are at the horizon. I think the biggest thing that we did was being able to keep pace with that change. The greatest contribution came in from our people. I mean, the people, the teams, all the teams, the editorial team, the commercial teams, the back-end team, the tech team. The second is the tech team, the technology team, the way they were able to innovate. In fact, as we speak, we've been able to do news channels, particularly ET Now, with less than single digit, I mean, with less than double digit people. I mean, between 7 to 9 people we have sometimes had in office running the whole channel without a problem, and the viewers actually have had no issue with you know, our new operation and processes. There is a lot of innovations that have happened. In fact, as we speak, we are currently working on certain pilots which can revolutionize not just broadcasting in India, but probably globally. We are really working on certain solutions which we are experimenting with. The pandemic put us in a desperate situation, and desperate situation demand such solutions, and also it also gives you the guts to talk, sort of take chances, and we took them. Of course, the content team has been exemplary. The most important you know, thing was that there were so many people at home, and there was fear in the air. And fear is a great, great ingredient to create stickiness. One can play on fear, and that temptation, I think the entire Times Network team has been able to keep it, keep away from such a temptation. We have been absolutely balanced. We have, right in the beginning, wanted to sort of fight fear with facts, and we stayed the course. We have been balanced. We have a, I think, you know, I'm happy that we've been able to sort of, in this kind of a situation where there have been certain stories which have just sort of broken all rules, I would say, you know, the Palghar story, the unfortunate death of Sushant Singh, and so on. We have been able to be the voice of reason and balanced, and probably have come out stronger. And, you know, I was telling somebody, in times when there is intense engagement, you know, even in personal relationships, suddenly you're put together in a project which demands everybody to work together. That is when, you know, the right impressions are made, and those impressions are carried for a long time. Similarly, we believe when there was such intense viewership, when people were sitting at home, there was no original content, people were wanting news channels. At that time, I think Times Network channels have been able to really, really, really improve their relationship with viewers, and that is for us to now maintain and nurture and continue with. And overall, I think it's been a bad year from the point of view of health and medical situation. But overall, I think economically And technologically and business-wise, I think this is a year that teaches us so much that the learnings from this 1 year, although coming at cost, will be the return on the learnings is going to be a lot more over the next 2 or 3 years. We are already seeing those results. I think all in all, we've had a fantastic coming together of people because it was a trying period, and for me, therefore, getting such a recognition in this year is so special. Thank you very much.